conversation is all about our messages, our mission. Then coming down to Niger State, what are we looking at? So what we have done as executives is to cross-fertilize ideas about what we want to do. So we wanted to take note of all those salient issues on how the end can be achieved from the beginning. So just like what Mr. Oshodi, the research and training coordinator, observed, that is, from our president, we have been able to see that pictures says it all. But I'm going to come from the academic point of view, so don't be disappointed. So you what you are going to see. So now my title is Strategic Plan for 2015-2016. So I'm going to stand on the shoulder of my chairman, who is unavoidably absent. So next slide, please. So, and the outline is from the mandate of CC to your contribution. So, I'm going to do that from the mandate to your contribution. Next slide. Next slide, please. So, the central argument of my presentation is I want to show. Next slide. Just press. That's how it's going to be. I control my. So, the framework for productive professional relevance in the year 2016 from Niger State CCN branch. Next. Now the association is about a non-profit organization made up of security professionals in Nigeria and diaspora. As a matter of fact, our president is from Nigeria and is from UK. You can see most of the statistics is giving us what is obtainable in Nigeria and that of UK. Next slide. Next. So our motto simply is to champion cybersecurity awareness and readiness. Awareness and readiness in Nigeria. Next. Now our vision is to be a vehicle for championing the cause and awareness of best practices in cybersecurity. And not only that, to act as an agent of change to address cyber criminal phenomena. You know, there is something about Nigeria. There is something about Nigeria that whenever they heard anything about us, there is this negative. In fact, there's some country that doesn't ship directly to Nigeria. So how are we going to do that? Our vision is to change that model to from negative to positive. People should be able to be confident that they want to do what? They want to do business with us. So that is our vision. So to do that, next slide. So we want to do a multifaceted program in cybersecurity industry. Number one, to hold any debates. To expand audience knowledge about these awareness and readiness that I'm talking about next. To share knowledge and grow the information security in Nigeria through conferences, workshops, and seminars. And that started last year. We had Cyber Secure 2015. This year, we're going to be having Cyber Secure 2016 in April. Then to educate organizations, public and cyber security threat safeguards, just like what we did in the university last year, Stop Team Connect. And next. To increase the awareness of cybersecurity issues amongst individuals, educational institutions, business and government. Next. Of course, to develop knowledge. To do that, we have to develop, just like our president has, you know, expand our horizon about the cybersecurity trends now and in the future. And to maintain relationship between individuals and organizations in the cybersecurity industry. Next. And of course, to advise governments on development of policy, law, legislation relating to cybersecurity, just like data protection law that we have identified in today's presentation. Then to provide ongoing forum to share learning, knowledge, skills, ideas in the cybersecurity. Last year, CCN organized ISACA CAFE, nearby members at Abuja to learn how to be certified on ISACA. And then make support services available for members and cyber security professionals within Nigeria. Of course, to create YouTube programs, forum, to breed future generations of information security professionals in Nigeria. From the last presentation, you can see There are several cybersecurity threats, but the professionals to mitigate these threats were still scarce. Next. So that is what we want to do. So in Niger State, we have registrars and AFLI members in all these tentacles. We have Mina, we have Kirin Lapai, we have Zungiru, Dina, Takura, Sumija, and Mokwa, which our plan is to. So these are the executives from myself, Vice Chairman, as we have seen during the inauguration. Next. Next. So our code of ethics, you know, most professional organizations actually sign into a kind of ethics that guide the practice. The fact that you are cybersecurity, you are informed about how to launch DDoS, how to do this, that doesn't mean that you have to use it to. So these are the code of ethics that we sign to discharge professional activity within our competency, to maintain confidentiality. Of course, as an agent, you are going to be a top level management officer. Then to refrain from any activities that will damage the reputation of CC. Of course, continuous professional development about the current trends of cybersecurity in Nigeria. So our targeted audience are the users, the service users. Everybody wants to go E now. So, you know, we started from mobile in the last presentation. What do we need to know about the phone? So we need to let people know about the danger, the threats, and the possible opportunities they can get from the E ecosystem. So community leaders, corporate organizations, and government for our starters. So this is our strategic plan monthly, month by month. So I'm doing that of February now, planning and adoption of the annual plan. So our next target is to use our flagship program, Stop Think Connect, to IBB University, Lapa. We have started our logistics around that. So we hope that by March 2016, we should be at IBBU University. So what I'm saying in essence is that we might actually call you as an emergency meeting as soon as the date has been concretized, because we are going to have banners, you know, so that we, apart from the university environment, even people in Lapai as a town can actually attend it, so that they can take advantage of our flagship program. Not only that, we're also looking at going to COE, College of Education in MENA, to actually go and launch our Stop Think Connect in April. In May, we want to go to Niger State Ministry of Science and Technology. Of course, after that, we are going to relax in June to all the, of course, there will be call, there will be requests from all these seminars. So we are going to use the knowledge that we gain based on our targeted audience to do a kind of capacity building for ourselves on ethical hacking and penetration testing. In July 2016, we'll go to Zungiru to launch the Stop Think Connect. Then, of course, we have the Federal College of Education in Butangura. So we are targeting August 2016 for that. Then, to engage with our populace, our consciousness, usually in October every year, has been declared as UN month for cybersecurity awareness. So we are going to actually have this in October, this program in October. So in November, of course, there should be an inclusive stakeholders meeting to consolidate our effort. Okay, if you look at all the places I've envisioned, we actually need to look at, okay, where are we to get it right? Because Stop Think Connect will just be a beginning to an end. They are going to request for so many, because we know there will be information security professionals over there who want us to liaise with them. Of course, we should have a kind of a branch annual cyber security lecture, perhaps National Conference Center in Lego, maybe we are going to plan towards that. And of course, we need to review. So, of course, to do this, we need to have updated knowledge. So to do that, we shall be attending conferences, Cyber Security Conference in 2016. So I want to encourage all our members, because as an expert, this is not something that the executive can do alone. Okay, we need people to come forward as resource persons. So we need to work on our knowledge about cyber security generally, computer security generally, network security generally. So we are planning to have capacity development training on Linux, connection training, and of course, we want the national headquarters to come and have ISACA training, at least towards the end of the year, towards this. So that will help us to fuse all our members, people from La Paz, Suleja, who can grow, they can converge to the center, and that will actually add value to our brand. Next. Now, how do we do this? Funding. So, we are going to get, these are the expected incomes. Of course, if you want the association to move on, we need funds. So, we are going to deliberate on what is going to be our benchmark. Because if you look at all these programs, virtually every month, we are going to be having at least one flagship program and one general meeting. So, we need funds to do that. Of course, grants, donations, fundraising, and selflessness, you know, to do that. Then, so, and those income is going to be invested in the following. Of course, for every program, we should have flyers that we are going to give to our audience. Then, of course, the logistics, the prow during and after, there should be funding for that. Then, of course, there should be adverts, like we should have something like this customized for Niger State. So wherever we are having our program, we should have something like this. Then, of course, monthly running costs. I want you to join me to give a round of applause to our Vice President, who gave us this city token. For, you know, you cannot just sit down for 2 hours without having someone that helped us with this. So that's why I said we are going to invest our resources in order to achieve those. Next slide. So the quarterly program, so to do that, we want it to be all inclusive because we are all experts. So the first quarter team is being championed by National Vice Chairman, myself, National Vice Chairman, Dr. Idris, myself, Branch Secretary, we need 2 members who are going to be reporting to give us the update about when we are for this first quarter. The first quarter are the first from March to like April. So they are going to plan towards the next. The second quarter, the branch chairman himself, the R&D, the branch financial secretary, and they are going to work towards that. Like writing letters, make sure they visit the place, give us all the logistics so that we are not. So the, all this, the next slide, next. The third quarter, the R&D, the PRO, the branch treasurer, the 2 members, they are going to help us on things that we need to take in terms of venues, in terms of the population, in terms of getting members to the venue. And of course, liaising with people in that place. Then the fourth quarter, which will now involve shaking hands with the national headquarters, you know, to actually review. Because all these programs, we actually need the presence of a representative, you know, because we are now, we'll be meeting the Senate, for example, in the university, they want, because it's usually a university-wide program. So we need somebody from the headquarters to, so that they will know that this is a serious association that has the presence both within MENA and within Nigeria. So in conclusion, future belongs to those who can see the future and plan for it now. And not only plan for it and act towards it. Next. So effective commitment of you as members will help us to achieve our vision. To be an agent of change to address our current phenomena in Nigeria. Thank you for, we want to now request your thoughtful contribution in this presentation. Thank you for listening.